Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel Applied Forensic Research Sciences.
Myself, Anushka Yadav, member of Applied Forensic Research Sciences. I am here to explain physical evidence in crime scene. So, today's topic is physical evidences in crime scene.
Here, we will discuss introduction of physical evidences, types of physical evidences on the basis of mobility, on the basis of source, biological evidences and chemical evidences. We will also discuss crime object and suspect object. So, what is physical evidences in crime scene? Physical evidences can be said to any object that establish a link between suspect and crime, or which we can represent as evidences against the suspect or criminal. In a court of law, types of physical evidences may vary according to type of crime. And also we can say physical evidences are the weapons against criminal and a step towards justice. We can consider many things as a physical evidences, such as semen, saliva, hair, nail, etc. Every crime scene is a unique in nature. So, kinds of physical evidences may vary about crime scenes and according to type of crime which is committed. In a crime scene, many contamination can happen to the physical evidences. Therefore, we need to package them carefully and handle them carefully to avoid these contaminations and provide them to the forensic lab. We can classify physical evidences on the basis of many criterias. First, we are going to touch types of physical evidences on the basis of mobility. So, there are two types of physical evidences on the basis of mobility. First, movable, and second, immovable. The movable kind of physical evidences are generally small in size, therefore, they can precisely pick up both willingly or non-willingly from the crime scene. And secondly, the immovable type of physical evidences are those evidences which are generally large in size, therefore they cannot be moved from the crime scene. Therefore, a forensic scientist must have to move further from crime scene as crime reported to prevent the contamination and erasing of the physical evidences. Basically, movable physical evidences. Then, here we are discussing the physical evidences on the basis of source. There can be three types of physical evidences on the basis of source, which is physical evidences from crime scene, physical evidences from culprit, and physical evidences from victim itself. The physical evidences which we can collect from crime scene is called physical evidences from crime scene, which can be footprints, nails, blood, semen, etc. Secondly, the physical evidences which we can collect from culprit can be his mobile location, murder weapons, etc. And lastly, the physical evidences which we can collect from victim himself can be body fluid, hair samples, etc. And then another category here is biological category of evidences, which is first body material, second body fluid, and then biological evidences. In body material, there can be many things such as injuries, teeth, bone, tissue, nail, etc. In body fluid category, some fluid like blood, semen, saliva, etc. can be put it. And then biological evidences such as hair, fiber, etc. can be put it. We can also recognize it as a biology which is directly related with a living body. So we can remember it as well. And here our next category, which is called as chemical evidences. Chemical evidences. So, what chemical is? Basically, here we consider chemical such as explosive, narcotics, petroleum and other igniters. So, there are three categories of chemical evidences in crime scene. First, explosive and residues. Second, narcotics. Third, petroleum and other igniters. So, explosive, which can cause a fire. So, these can be anything explosive. Narcotics can also bring a direction towards justice. So, it is also considered as a chemical evidences. And then, petroleum products or igniters can also consider as a chemical evidences in crime scene, such as petrol, diesels, kerosenes and other motor oils. So, here we classified chemical evidences of crime scene. So, our new topic is crime object. So, what is crime object? Basically, crime object is material or anything which can establish the origin and association regarding to crime scene, which can help to recreate the time. Or can say it is an unknown questioned sample through which we can further detect the situation of crime. In our previous slide, we have gone through crime object. Now, the turn of suspect object. So, what is suspect object? Suspect object is basically a comparison object, reference sample whose origin are previously known. It is used to establish identity, source, association and individuality with crime scene. The main difference between crime object and suspect object is we already know the origin of suspect object. So this was suspect object. In previous video, we discussed types of cybercrime and a basic question about it was asked. So, the question was, which one of the following is a computer threat? The answer is DOS attack. I hope you all get it right. So, as usual, I am here asking you a question, which is basically a multiple choice question. So, the question is, which component of blood contains genetic information? That is DNA. Here the option is, first, WBC, that is white blood cells. Second, RBC, that is red blood cells. Third, leukocytes. And fourth, both first and third. So tell me in comment box, did you get it? Hurry up fast. And thank you for being throughout the video and listening me carefully. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe the channel. And also hit the bell icon for latest updates. Thank you so much from Applied Forensic Research Sciences.